r/AskReddit. Crime investigators. What's the creepiest and solved case you investigated that scares you to this day? Back in the early 80s, a 16-year-old boy was walking home from a party about a mile from his house when he was intentionally hit by a vehicle and dragged by the vehicle before being dumped in front of his house for his father to find his body in the morning. The police say they have suspects but not enough evidence to make any arrests. There are still posters all over the town and surrounding areas with his picture asking for information more than 35 years later. Really a tragic story that needs closure. I work as an investigator for the County Medical Examiner. The cases that always creep me out are the Jean and John Does, especially the younger ones. How could a family not report a loved one missing for 10, 20 or 30 years? Some of these cases are not suspicious, so it's not like the family is worried about going to prison. We're looking at forensic genealogy to assist with some of the cases. In a town close to me, a few years ago a little boy went missing. He was in a foster home with his siblings. There was apparent previous reports from neighbors of them wandering off frequently because they were left alone without food, breaking into garages I think. He was reported missing by the foster mom. She went on TV and everything I think I remember. There were so many search parties. We live in the desert so there's a lot of open land. I stopped hearing things about it. Eventually I asked one of my buddies who works in that PD and he told me they never got any real answers. They found remains years later that they believed to be his in a canal. But it had been so long not much was left. Also they think wild animals had probably spread what was left of the remains around after all these years. Someone killed 50 dogs and left them on top of parked cars for a year. Then it just stopped. It's frightening because it makes me think they've moved on to people. Worked in forensics 2004 to 2008. Mostly rapes, homicides, and cold cases. Never forgot one where a baby was abused because a burglar threatened to kill the entire family if the parent didn't do it. Wasn't solved before I left and nothing came up on Google. Never forgot names. The idea that someone out there free is that ducked up or that someone would make that shit up is so disturbing to me. Wait, what now? The burglar made the parent abuse their own baby? That's one of the most ducked up things I've ever heard. Luxy for you. You haven't read the write-ups of some of the most horrid, awful crimes out there, even in recent years. The worst that comes to mind for me was the Dardeen family homicides. Reading about it alone is traumatizing. Do not recommend. The mother was pregnant and gave birth during the assault and the baby was killed too. Cold case to boot. There are some sick ducking humans that breathe the same air as us. Someone was picking up drunk homeless people in my town. About 20 years back. Beating them up and dropping them far from town during the winter season. Which can last for about 2 to 8 months and drop as low as minus 45 Celsius. I'm not an investigator, but this happened to a little girl in my brother's class and a friend from school. My friend was a happy-go-lucky, chubby guy that everyone liked. He smoked a little weed from time to time which made it hard for him to keep a job. One day he goes missing and is found in his barn swinging from a rafter by a friend of his. Suicide note. No ladder or any way for him to have gotten up to the rafter. No typical signs of depression or suicide such as saying goodbye to loved ones. Taking care of loose ends, etc. Gets written off as a suicide. Case temporarily closed. 6-year-old girl was missing from her home in the morning. Found in the barn hanging from the rafter and raped molested with a knife. Stepdad had porn of her on his computer and somehow was cleared on the murder by pinning it on a teenage neighbor. Neighbor kid claimed stepdad put him up to it and smoked weed with him but there was no evidence to convict and the teenager went to jail for murder while stepdad got a reduced sentence for child porn. Neither got a drug charge which was also weird. The reason I mentioned these together? Stepdad was the friend who called in my friend's death. After no luck with the county I anonymously messaged Channel 5 and they had to reopen after it was reported publicly that they missed something. Forensic analysts said the suicide note was faked. Suddenly the detective on the case finds there was a ladder present. Ray closed the case and retired. Dude got away with murder. Twice in one case and once in another. I'd consider both unsolved till the right guy goes down for them. Two girls in their 20s round murdered in their car. McDonald's food in their laps. Windows up. Doors locked. No sign of a struggle. was my last case I ever worked. 3 years ago. No suspects have been arrested. Murdered how? Gunshots to the back of the head. Mystery was solved a few days after it happened, but I figured I would share anyways. In the town I live in, there's a rundown motel that all the druggies stay at. Well, anyways, there was a night that a man walked into and pulled out a sawed-off shotgun and blew the cashier's brains all over the wall. Stole $112 and some change. Obviously, our investigation was opened, and for 4 days they didn't have any leads or anything. Turns out on the evening of the fourth night, they supposedly found the murderer behind the motel in a cornfield in a fetal position, just rocking back and forth. At my first department, someone was stringing up dogs in the trees behind houses with their throats cut and bled dry. Serial killer behavior. Obviously just killing them to kill them. Worked on that case a couple weeks, but after 4 or 5 dogs, it just stopped and my bosses wouldn't let me work on it anymore with all the real crime going on. I still think it was a future serial killer practicing. Beach killing good boys is a duck in real crime. Not an investigator. In League City TX, there used to be a dead-end road. The city grew like crazy. In the process of clearing land, they found dozens of girls buried. Still several unidentified. They stumbled onto the dumping ground for a serial killer. It's called a road if you're familiar with that area. They did a documentary on it at some point. My sister went to prom with a guy who lived next door to this. One night she is over at his house and a random girl comes running. No shows on, screaming. Banging on the door saying some guy picked her up or was following her. Boys say the man was nowhere to be found. Prom date and brother get her to safety, then proceed to tell my sister all the weird ghost stories because weird things like that always happen around here. They thought she was spooked by feelings of being watched or something. Until a few years later when they started finding bodies. Again. Edit. Reached out to my sister for full details. This is her story. Okay. So it was some girl from Angelton got in a wreck in front of the house by the field. She comes running to the house. No shoes on. This girl tells them some guy was following her. He was trying to run her off the road. Blocked her car, forcing her down this road. Called her. The road was dark, she didn't feel right. She saw the lights on in their house. So she wrecked her car as she jumped out and ran to the back door. Boys got her inside, then saw flashlights around their house. Which apparently happened often. Keep her inside long enough to feel like whoever it was left drove away. Only to realize during all this she had been drugged. That's why she didn't feel right. Call cops. Man was picking up girls at a bar on NASA Road 1 and drugging them. So they caught at least one creep. Bodies were found there from the 70s till I think 2000s. Fun fact. She tells me that apparently now there is a subdivision over these killing fields. There's a man who comes into the bar I work at every day around 4 p.m. He's nice. Has a group of other guys he socializes with. His wife comes in every Sunday with him for football season. Their daughter went missing a few years ago. They had a suspect, who my older sister actually dated for a short period. When they couldn't definitively connect him to the case, they cut him loose. He's now serving time for a completely separate kidnapping murder. He hasn't confessed to the first one, so the couple will never really know if they caught a guy. Everyone just assumes. I don't think the family will ever get closure off of an assumption though. What does your sister say about the guy? It was like 10 years ago. Long before any of this happened. One of the guys she dated before she cleaned up her act. Partying. Drugs. She's married with kids now and doesn't really like to talk about be associated with him. Which is understandable. It's a small town. Not a criminal investigator, but I do CPS joint investigations. We'll never fully know what one little girl went through as she was very young. She's doing very well now. But she had nightmares for years of a big gray man that would come into her room at night. Horrible case of sexual abuse. Really shook me. Hinterkaifeck murders, 1922 Germany. Creepy sounds in a barn and an entire rural family is slaughtered, including a maid who had just arrived. Evidence at the scene showed that the killer had stayed in the home for several days, lit a fire, and fed the animals. Nothing valuable was taken. A local girl went missing about 2 years ago. Whole community and neighboring communities got involved. Had a hashtag they painted on car windows and everything. Tried like crazy to find her. The parents still hold out hope. But I'm not convinced they really do. And it's devastating to watch. I have friends that know the family. I have two young girls, and this is a fear that my job forces me to take home with me, that one day they'll disappear and that's it. There are some sex trafficking hotspots nearby. A week after that girl disappeared, I told my wife she was most likely already dead. Poor kiddo. I hope she is still alive and she escapes and the disgusting people who captured her are held to justice. The 35-pound bags of human vomit that appeared in the PKG lot of the Radnor, Par Bed Bath & Beyond. For a few weeks, the woman on Philly walking to the Acme MKT, who thought someone ran by and hit her accidentally. She shopped for 30 minutes at Acme, then walked home and her daughter discovered a chef's knife lodged in her neck. No one at Acme said anything and the knife was visible on surveillance. Someone had been leaving half-eaten fish all over West London, as Encounter bought fresh fish, scales and all. It was an ongoing cold case cause the saliva was the same on each one. No one was really victimized by it though, so we never got a chance to properly look into it. I'm not sure I understand. What's the crime? Littering? No crime. It's just really fishy. Thanks for gold and silver's kind strangers. All the people going missing in federal parks. FBI does not track them. Guesses are 1,600 slash it disappear and some are not found. It happens at an alarmingly high rate compared to other places. My father was a police officer some time ago. While in school his platoon was called with every other policeman in region. A kid was missing. They were looking for him for quite some time. Yet they did not found him. He was supposed to be somewhere in small forest near the town he was living in. Kid just sunk. After some time people would contact police and say that kid was seen almost 500 kilometers away, alone. They had many suspects but all got their alibi. The case was open for almost 20 years and was closed like 10 years ago. We'll try to find some info about it edit post. But here in Poland we do not put such information to public. Not a crime investigator but Dairo Aking went missing about a decade ago and was found in boxes. It is estimated that she was cut up into around 2,000 pieces. When they put her back together they were missing a heart, spleen and liver. My personal theory is black market organ transplants. To sell or to use I don't know. Maybe to sell because the heart sells for around $1 million USD on the black market. Jesus. Imagine being the team that had to put her back together. That's the stuff of nightmares. There are pictures of her reassembled online. Not a very pretty sight. Why the actual shit am I reading this at 3 a.m? On my town we found a dead body in the middle of a street. A good neighborhood. Never figured out who was this person since nobody ever filed a missing person for him. Creepy part? He was beheaded. And the head was inside his stomach. What the Christ. Not one myself. But this case shocked everyone. Girl went missing. Pregnant at the time. 36 weeks. Police interviewed everyone. The boyfriend. The other boyfriend. Friends. Mother. Neighbors. Etc. Body was found almost a year and a half later. On a shed. Not 100 yards from her house. The killer tied her up. And buried her alive. All the while she was on labor. Then covered her with concrete. When found. The baby was halfway through the birthing canal. Head already out. Case is still ongoing. They have a suspect but there is still a couple of years away from anything concrete. Whoa. You made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, mate. It's free and that's a great price.